Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the fourth installment of our Imagine Sessions. I hope you're all well and have had a nice couple of weeks. For those of you who haven't been to one of our sessions before, I think you all have, but just as a bit of a reminder, my name is Lyle, and I'm here with Emily. Emily, do you want to say hello?
Hello, everyone.
And I'm also here with Andrew. Andrew, do you want to say hello?
Hello, good morning.
And the three of us make up Wild Geese Theatre Company. We create theatre for young people like you all over the country. Firstly, parents and guardians, before you leave everyone to it, we want to once again share with you our website, www.wildgeesetc.co.uk/imagine, where you can find all of the information that you will need to upload your work, or just to keep in touch with us with everything you've been doing. You can find everything you will need on there in terms of getting in contact with us. The Facebook links, Twitter, Instagram. We love seeing all of your amazing creations. So please do check out the link and get sharing after this session. Now, throughout this morning, there are going to be a few times that we get up on our feet and move around. So can you all take a moment and put one of your favorite exercises in the chat? So maybe something like shaking it out or jumping around or running on the spot, any of those favorite exercises, and pop them in the chat in this window. And I'll tell you what as well, what might actually be really fun, the next time we stop when we do one of these exercises, we might be able to play one of your favorite songs as well. So why don't you pop your favorite song in the chat as well, and we'll be able to do that exercise along with your favorite song. Brilliant stuff. So we've had Jumping Jacks, amazing, from Amelia, to Bad Guy by Billie Eilish. What a great song that is. Running in Slow Motion from Andrew. Any Dream Will Do. What a great song, a fabulous song. These are great. Yeah, what sort of exercises might we be doing as well? Fabulous. Star Jumps. Yeah, Jumping Jacks, Star Jumps. Going to keep nice and active this morning. Brilliant. We'll keep putting those suggestions in the chat. Keep having to think. And the next time we get up and do a bit of exercise, we'll use one of those suggestions that you've given us. So really well done indeed. Now, the next thing I want to point you in the direction of is If I Were You. Now, If I Were You is an area on our Facebook where you can share all of the ideas of fun things to do whilst we're all stuck at home. So can you all take a moment and think about two of your favorite things that you've done whilst you've been at home over the last few weeks, and write those in the chat to share with one another as well. And then once you've shared those ideas, we can upload them to that If I Were You section, and we'll have a lovely big list of the favorite things that you've been doing at our fingertips in case we get bored. So let's see some of these suggestions. Brilliant. Oh, I've done 100 star jumps in a minute. Fabulous. Really well done, Elise, amazing. Cooking and cycling, as we've discussed, amazing. Lego as well. Baking and reading out loud, fabulous. Yeah, lots of baking and cooking been going on, hasn't it? So great, yeah, we'll definitely be sure to put that on our Facebook. Random journey on my bike. Brilliant stuff. Oh, Sophia, heads for left, tails for right. That's incredible. Lots of reading as well from Amelia. Lots of reading. Brilliant stuff. These are great suggestions, and we'll be sure to put those on our Facebook group when we can after this session. Good morning, Ulfa, as well. Ulfa's just joined us. Good morning as well. Great to see you. Brilliant. Those are amazing suggestions. Now, we've been on our bottoms for a little bit so far, so I think it might be time for our first exercise. Emily, can you tell us what exercise we will be doing?
Well, Lyle, I think it's only right that you start out with some jumping jacks.
Jumping jacks, spot on. Okay, everyone, up on your feet. I'm going to move around this side of my sofa here. I'm going to do jumping jacks for a minute, really quickly. One, two, three, go. There we go. Oh, keep me nice and active. Nice and warm. There we go. Brilliant. Maybe five more. One, two, three, four, five. That's a great song to do some jumping jacks to as well. Really well done. And quickly get back and sat down. There you go. Really well done. Now, just remember, I forgot to remind you, just remember that when we do that exercise, it's always important we have as much space as we can around us so there are no slips and trips. So you saw I moved over to a nice big space over there. I'm always really amazed with how much better I feel after a bit of exercise. I always feel a lot more happy and a lot healthier as well. Right, now that our bodies are ready, let's get our minds ready too. We're gonna do a bit of a quick fire competition. So everyone, get your detective hats on. In a moment, we're going to put two pictures up once again, as we've done before, and we're going to see how quickly we can complete the spot the difference. So let's pop those two pictures up and get putting the differences you can spot in those two pictures in the chat as you've been doing so far. Now, this is a really tricky one this week, but you've been doing so well at this over the last few sessions. We thought we'd give you a bit of a tricky one. So I know you're going to be brilliant at this once again. So pop those differences in the chat. Yeah, crab, brilliant. Yeah, just having a look myself, actually. Crab on the Rock, yeah. Both Elise and Amelia have spotted the crab. Rock as well, brilliant. But yeah, oh, I can see that one as well. Alpha, brilliant stuff, really well done. Fish. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, the fish. Brilliant stuff. Really well done, Elise. Fabulous. Any Dream will do as well. Beer's suggestion. Love this song. Brilliant. Some great song suggestions. Keep looking for those differences. Like I said, a very tricky one. What's different about, yeah, Andrew. Andrew's saying, what's different about the mermaid? Can anyone spot any differences in the mermaid? Perhaps the hair of the mermaid. Maybe something to do with the coral reef and the mermaid, maybe. Seaweed crown looks different. Yeah, that's the one. There you go. Yeah, around the reef in her hair, the seaweed crown. Brilliant stuff, Amelia. Really well spotted. Yeah, head, brilliant. Quite a tricky one today. Really well done, Elise, as well. Brilliant. I knew you guys would be good at this one this week. You've already done so much better than I did. Emily's saying that's all seven. I think you could be right as well. Really well done. Super speedy work as well, because that was a really tricky one this week. So you guys did so brilliantly to get all those differences. And we'll be sure to put another one of those up next time we all meet again. Okay. Detective hats off and imagination caps on. For those of you who are new to these sessions, we've had a brilliant time using our imaginations to create an imaginary friend. We've also created their home and the community that they live in as well. There were no rules at all, so they could literally be anything. And your wonderful imaginations have come up with some really wonderful and pretty wild creations. And here are just a couple of examples of your wonderful work. Now, we've had a brilliant response to this. Sophia sent us in another tour of her community, a video tour, which we absolutely loved watching. So amazing work, Sophia, really building up that picture. And Elise and Panda built a Lego community, as we've been hearing. Elise told us that earlier on, and we really love looking through the Lego community that you built. Really, really incredible creations that you both sent in. Thank you so much. And if we haven't mentioned you as well, thank you for all of your brilliant work so far in creating this imaginary friend, their community and their home. Thank you so much for sending those in. Now, as a result of how brilliant all that work was, I think it might be time to get back on our feet and have a quick celebratory exercise. So Emily, what have you got in store for us for a celebration exercise?
We are gonna be doing a slow motion run. Lila,
slow motion run.
Slow mo running.
Okay, slow mo run. Let's give this one a go. Right, so lots of space, up on our feet, lots of space, and a slow motion run. I'm going to do it to the side. Bit of slow motion. And back down we go. A bit of slow motion running there. Brilliant stuff. Superb. Really well done. So slow motion running as well. That's really, really tough work as well. So brilliant. Fabulous stuff. It's always important to keep active and also to just be a bit silly. A bit of slow motion diving there. I've knocked my sheep off the sofa. Never mind. She's fine. Fabulous stuff. Now, over the last three sessions, we've created some really incredible things with our imaginations. We started by creating a new imaginary friend, then we dreamt up their home, and last time we even built the community that they live in. You should all be so proud of your awesome imaginations. And now we're going to go on a big adventure. I would like you all to picture your imaginary friend in your minds right up here with as much detail as possible. For those of you who weren't here last time, let's think of one now together. And for those of you that have been here for previous sessions, you can keep your wonderful imaginary friend that you've created so far for this adventure, or you can come up with a new one if you decide to do that. The possibilities are endless with this. They can literally be anything, maybe something that humans haven't even discovered yet. The only rule is they need to be super creative. So have a think in your head. Don't put anything in the chat yet. What type of creature are they? What type of creature is this imaginary friend? How big or small are they? What color are they? What color is this creature? And also, do they have any special qualities or powers? Keep this new friend in your head. Really use those imaginations and keep that new friend in your head. Now, I would like you all to imagine that you have just been washed up on a desert island. I'm going to ask you all some questions. I want you to write down your answers in chat. Now, when you do write those answers, as we've done before, don't press send or enter straight away. When you have an idea for all of the questions written down in a list, then you can click send. So maybe when you're writing your answers, maybe put a full stop after each answer or a comma, and then press space and then write those answers. Brilliant. We've already got something from Elise Panda and Bob, who is an alien. Amazing, Elise. Brilliant. So keep that in the chat just for now, and then answer these questions and click send after. And we'll read these suggestions out afterwards. Now remember, there is no right or wrong here. No suggestion is a bad suggestion. Let's really paint the picture of this incredible adventure. Okay, keep those imagination caps on. First question I would like to ask you all is this. How on earth did you get here? How did you travel here? How did you get to this island? And what happened on your journey to mean that you ended up on this island? So you were traveling somewhere, and what happened that meant that you got to this island? What happened on your journey? Now you're on the island, what can you see in front of you? What's in front of you on this island? And then if we look to our right and to our left, what can we see around us? What can we see on our right and on our left? What's the weather like on this island? What sort of weather do we have on this island? What noises can you hear around you? You've got some lovely ocean waves noises, but what other noises might you hear around you as well? What kind of creatures are on this island? Great and small, what kind of creatures are on this island? What fruits can you see growing on the trees? What sort of fruits are on this island? And also, what do those fruits taste like? What do those fruits taste like growing from the trees on this island? And also around you, what could you use to build yourself a shelter on this island? How did you and your friend feel when you got to this island? Did you have different reactions? Or did you feel the same? Pop those answers to all of those questions. I'm going to give you a little bit of time just to answer those questions. You've already had some great suggestions. Pop them all in a list and then press send on the chat. Answers to all those questions. Oh, amazing. We've had some amazing suggestions. Brilliant. Amazing work, everyone. Press send on those answers. And Emily, do you want to read some out?
Oh, I would absolutely love to read some out. We have so Panda and Bob, who's the alien, they were flying and they crashed. All around them they can see sea, they can see trees. The fruits taste nice and they're gonna use wood to build their shelter. And then we have two people who teleported really, really fast. There's palm trees and weird animals. It's really, really hot, like today. They can hear birds squawking. I love that word. They've got coconuts there growing on the trees. Wow, and they're gonna use driftwood to build a shelter. And they were really, really surprised to land there because they didn't mean to go there at all when they were teleporting. Then we have Sophia, who, her friend has wings, so she flew on her back and they played trampolining on the clouds. They were really, really excited. You can see lots of beautiful trees around them. It's tropical, it's really, really sunny. And she can hear fairies and desert animals. And she can see oranges, which taste really, really nice. And they're gonna use wood from the trees to build a shelter. And then we had Ulfa, who got there on a boat. It's sunny, there's waves, and there's scorpions on the island.
Wow.
With lots of apples and leaves to build a shelter. Wonderful suggestions, everybody.
Absolutely amazing. So many amazing pictures as well that we built up there in our minds of some really incredible things on these islands. So really, really well done for all your truly brilliant suggestions. That was amazing stuff. Keep those ideas really alive in your head. Brilliant stuff. Okay, in a moment, I'm going to ask you all to get a pen or some colouring pencils and some paper, and we're going to sketch out a quick map or picture of this incredible island, maybe based on some of the suggestions you've just made as well. Now, I'm only going to give you a minute to do this, but we'll quickly put as much detail in as possible as we can now, and then you can finish these maps after the session. Send them into us as well, because we want to see all of that brilliant work, just so that you can keep all of your fantastic suggestions fresh in your mind, and we can't wait to see them. Okay, so I'm going to give you a minute to quickly grab some colouring pencils, grab a pen, and have a draw, a sketch of the map of this island. As much detail as you can, and like I say, you can finish those off later on. So get drawing, everybody. Very soothing. Ocean waves playing. Very brilliant. Fabulous stuff. Get sketching those maps of the island. Be as big or small, as great and small as you want. Really think about what's on this island. What can we see? Gonna give you 10 more seconds. I've lost count. I'm gonna see if my sheep can. No, sheep doesn't have any fingers. That's not gonna work. Let's call it there. Time is up. Time is up. Really brilliant stuff, everyone. Time is up for now, but as I said, please finish those after this session is done. You've got loads of time to finish those and send those into us. They can be anything, a drawing, anything like that. Okay. We've been doing a lot of using our imaginations and really visualizing this island, doing a bit of drawing, I think it might be time to do a bit of something active. Emily, can you give us an exercise we can do just after we've drawn our islands?
I absolutely can. You're going to shake it off, Lyle. I want to see your best. Shake it off.
Brilliant. I love shaking it off. Get lots of space. Lots of space around you. Have a big shake. Really, really, really shake everything off. Really good stuff. Getting ourselves nice and ready for the day. Maybe do a spin. Oh, this is fabulous stuff. Fabulous. And have a sit back down, everyone. Amazing. Brilliant stuff. Always feels so much better after shaking it off. Brilliant. Now, I want to share with you a poem about a tropical island. Listen very carefully to some of the rhymes, as we're going to try and create our very own poems after this. So listen carefully to this poem. Tropical fruits ripening fast, rainbow flowers peeking through the grass, white shells and sand underneath your feet, sweet smelling air like your favorite treat, sparkling ocean, wide and blue. I'm going to swim. What about you? So there's a poem about a tropical island. Now I would like all of us to write a poem together. So I'm going to give you the like you to write the next line. So try and rhyme with the last word of each line. So our first line is, I can smell the sea when the wind blows. So what might rhyme with that? I can smell the sea when the wind blows. And pop your suggestions in the chat as well for rhymes of that line. I can feel the sand underneath my toes. Amazing, Amelia, really brilliant. I like swimming in the sea when the wind goes. These are brilliant, everybody. So I can smell the sea when the wind blows. I can feel the sand underneath my toes. I like swimming in the sea when the wind goes. I can feel the water in between my toes. Brilliant. There you go. Fabulous. And the next line is, I can feel the sand under my feet. So what rhymes with I can feel the sand under my feet? I can feel the sand under my feet. Pop those suggestions in the chat. And the final line is, I can hear sweet birds as they start to sing. And feel my heart doing its beat. I like the fruits that I can eat. So yeah, I can feel the sand under my feet. I like the fruits that I can eat and feel my heart doing its beat. I've missed one as well. I can see small clouds as they float by. By is a lovely rhyming word, isn't it? There's lots of things we could rhyme with by. So yeah, those four lines you can see there on the screen. What might rhyme with those? So we've got, I can feel the sand under my feet. I like the fruits that I can eat and feel my heart doing its beat. These are brilliant, really amazing. I can see small clouds as they float by. What might rhyme with that? And dance to the beat. Elise, amazing. And dance to the beat. Brilliant. And finally, as I said, I can hear sweet birds as they start to sing. I can hear sweet birds as they start to sing. What might rhyme with that? The word sing. Oh, amazing. Sophia, we've got, I can see small clouds as they float by. I love the sand and there I lie. Amazing. You guys are amazing poets. You really are. These are fabulous. going to give you one more minute, maybe just to try and find something that might rhyme with I can hear sweet birds as they start to sing. What might rhyme with sing? My heart starts to beat, I hear it ring. Emily, brilliant. I was digging and found a lovely little ring. Oh, amazing. Brilliant stuff, Sophia, amazing. Fabulous stuff. You guys have done absolutely brilliantly once again. What incredible poets you all are. You should be hugely proud of yourselves. Really brilliant stuff. Now, after all that amazing poetry, I think it might be time for our final exercise. Emily, what are we going to be doing?
I think it's only right, given that we had three suggestions for it, I think we need to do jumping jacks again.
Jumping jacks again? Spot on, right? Get yourself some space. You've got lots of huge space here around a nice safe space and some jumping. We're going to do 10 jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3.
Someone can be low, some a little bit shy. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me without making me try?
Jumping to jumping jacks. Maybe one for luck. Amazing. I've no doubt you've all done that a lot faster than me. Brilliant stuff. Keeping nice and active. Jumping jacks as well. Brilliant. One of my favourite exercises, that. So, we're nearly at the end of another brilliant session. Thank you all so much for your amazing creativity, your suggestions, your poetry. Once again, you've shown that your imaginations are truly boundless. Here are your missions for next time, for 2 weeks' time. The first one is grand designs. Now, let's have a think and have a look at our deserted island. How is it laid out? What does the island include? What does the island have on it? Maybe draw a map of your deserted island. Imagine all the different locations on this island. You might want to include things like buried treasure, where the animals are, where your camp is, and maybe where it's too dangerous to go as well. Maybe there might be some places it's too dangerous to go to. If you're feeling extra creative, you can also write a little detail about the different places on the island. The next mission is Dear Diary. It's a writing mission. Now, May is National Share a Story Month. Why not write a short diary from the point of view of your imaginary friend? You could include the date at the top of it, a list of things they do each day, how they're feeling on the deserted island. And if you're craving another challenge, you could also maybe write a short story that includes you and your imaginary friend and the time you spent on this island. So what you got up to, how you got there, like we were discussing earlier. The next mission is the sea, the sun, I skip and run. Now, you have all just proven just how amazing you are writing poetry. And why not write a short poem that takes us on a journey across your deserted island? And in that poem, you could tell us about the sights and the sounds and the smells we would all experience as we went on this journey. And finally, make it mighty. Make it mighty. Here are a few make it mighty options for you to choose from as well, while you make your imaginary island, while you create this imaginary island. And we've seen a few earlier in the show and tell as well. You can make a survival video about your island, how you might survive on this island. You can use Lego or building blocks to build your island and show us your island that way. You can maybe draw up a plan to escape from the island, or even make a poster to warn people about going to this island, or even to maybe encourage them to go to the island. If it's a nice island, maybe it could be a poster advertising the island maybe as well. So those are your missions, should you choose to accept them. And we can't wait to see all of your amazing suggestions. Finally, before we let you go this week, we have our Jumbotron. Now the Jumbotron, as ever, gives you all a chance to shout out your friends, your classmates, your teachers, any family that you might want to give a shout out to. It can be anyone. Just send in your shout outs to us and we'll include as many as we possibly can in our next session in just 2 weeks' time. And we can even do some now as well. Does anyone have a shout out that they would like to do now. If you do, you can pop it in the chat like we've been using so far, and I will do those shout outs now. These sessions get recorded, so you can then send those to your friends or family after the end of this session to show them that you've been shouting out and trying to say hello to them. So let's see. Has anybody got any shout outs they'd like to do? Oh, Elise, to her friend Brooke. Hello, Brooke, from Elise. That's lovely stuff, Elise. Sending a shout out to her friend Brooke. Brilliant stuff, everybody. And Amelia, her best friend Tallulah, and Miss Kukovic. Thank you for the pronunciation in the brackets there, Miss Kukovic. And Tallulah, that's from Amelia. Brilliant stuff, everyone. Like I say, if you don't want to do the shout out now, send those shout outs into us and we'll put them in our next session and we'll do a shout out for your friend or family member next session. Amazing. Now remember, all of the missions that I've just set you will be up on the Facebook group and website, and there are lots of resources on the Facebook group that can help you with those missions. Oh, Elise as well, her friend JJ, sending a shout out to her friend JJ. Hello, JJ. Brilliant stuff. Now, all of those missions and all of the other useful resources will be on our Facebook group, which you can see there on the screen now, as well as our Instagram, Twitter, and our email address as well, if you want to send us in any work. And whoever sends in their missions will also get sent a certificate of awesomeness. Now, you know you're awesome. We know you're awesome. So let's celebrate just how awesome you are by sending you a certificate that shows you're awesome, that certificate of awesomeness. So we can't wait to see what you come up with and send lots of those certificates out. Thank you so much for all of your amazing suggestions this morning. You really have been so brilliant. And always remember, there is no greater or more powerful tool than our imaginations. You guys have been fantastic. We can't wait to see you again in our next session. We can't wait to see all of your amazing work. But for now, we're going to say a big goodbye. Andy and Emily, do you want to say goodbye as well?
Bye, everyone. You're absolutely awesome. Thank you.